maybe the next one isn't. I mean, sure as hell sounds promising. The Creeping Terror. But it isn't. It's another crappy sci-fi flick, and this time we're really scraping the bottom of the genre. I told you so.
Oh my god, this movie is a mess. Let's see. A spaceship's crashed on Earth, so this sluggish monster, I guess, is out there devouring people. And this one sheriff guy, together with some other people, try to stop him. Sounds bad? Well, that's because it is. Now, take a look at a random scene. See if you notice anything strange.
Bradford thanked the colonel for his assistance, and then asked to speak to Martin. Bradford questioned Martin about everything that had transpired. Martin did his best to recall everything in precise detail, but really didn't have much for him.
That is kind of a weird dialogue, isn't it? What happened is, apparently all the audio recordings got lost, or destroyed, or whatever made. Whatever the actual case was, the director had half the movie narrated in post-production, resulting in a narration that most of the time just describes what the actors are saying or doing. It's ridiculous.
When Martin asked him if he had any luck in communicating with the beast, Bradford confessed that he hadn't, but would try again when certain data was returned to him from computer processing.
Combine that with a mini subplot about how life changes after marriage.
Since time began, this change in relationship has probably happened to all buddies in similar circumstances. Life has its way of making boys grow up, and with marriage, Martin's time had come.
And you got yourself a real winner. This movie is so bad. The monster is slow as hell and looks extremely stupid. Fortunately for the monster, he isn't as stupid as his victims, who do nothing but wait for them to be devoured. In some cases, the victims actually have to put effort in being devoured. Besides that, it's just pretty boring. Scenes take way too long. Sometimes you're watching minutes of whatever without any narration. You have no idea what's going on.
It was almost an hour before Caldwell learned.
Yeah, I think it was actually an hour. Then there is this dance scene that literally goes on for over 5 minutes, just people dancing. Even when the monster arrives, it takes him more than 3 minutes to go through the whole room. It's really not that big. I don't know about this one. Half the time I fell asleep, the other half I didn't know what was going on. The Creeping Terror? More like the Sleeping Terror.
So bad it's, I don't know, it's kinda funny and entertaining, but also extremely boring at times, so in the end, still pretty bad. And that, boys and girls, brings us to the last movie on this list. It's Battlefield Earth. I kept this movie for the last because wherever I look up something about this movie, it's always mentioned that it's the worst movie ever made, or at least one of the worst. And I honestly never saw it, so now I did. Doesn't look that bad, does it? I mean, yeah, let's take a look at the movie. Or well, I just did, but let's do it.
It's the year 3000, and for 1,000 years already, humans are being suppressed by this race of evil aliens. Until now, when this one badass tries to stand up to them. And that's the story, very simply put. The plot is very, very shaky, lots of plot holes and whatnot, but I don't know, the movie isn't that bad. Well, some plot holes are way too big. For example, the Rebellion, they find these military aircrafts. Not only do they work perfectly fine after collecting dust for 1,000 years, the people that didn't understand the concept of math learn within a week how to use these aircrafts. That's just complete and utter bullshit. They can't expect us to accept that, that's not even suspension of disbelief anymore. The production design and special effects aren't the greatest, but they're also far from the worst, I'd say. The reason this movie is hated on so much is, I think, because it's a relatively big budget film, especially compared to the other movies on this list. It had big name actors like John Travolta, and then there's the whole connection to the Church of Scientology. But that's a whole other story. Back to the movie. The movie is just pretty dull. The story is quite stupid, a lot of things don't make any sense. The acting is mediocre, the special effects aren't the greatest. Everything is shot under a tilted angle. It's just overall not so great. I honestly don't know what to say about this one. I mean, it's not like Robot Monster or The Creeping Terror, where it's fun to make fun of the movie. It's actually not even fun to talk about this movie in general.
I know, that wasn't the greatest review I've ever made, but let's just justify that by saying that Battlefield Earth also wasn't really the greatest movie ever made. In other words, it's so bad, it's not really worth checking out. Those were some bad movies. Maybe not as memorable as the ones in the first part. I mean, you can't touch the room. Me and my girl, we quote or reference that movie on a daily basis. Don't really see that happening with Disaster Movie, for example. But at least, they were bad. If I could find some more worthy, so bad it's good movies, I'd probably make a third part. Shouldn't be too hard, right? But until then, have a lovely day.